Hey everyone, I am back with a new video, and this is going to be a drawing workstation tour or drawing workspace tour, which was requested quite a few times, which is why I'm making this video. And there has been a lot of changes with my workspace. First of all, the major change is that everything is now under a loft bed. You can kind of see the ladder right over there on the far left. And yeah, so I will take you guys through my drawing workspace where I spend most of my time, pretty much, where I do a lot of my work and all of my YouTube videos in here. So let's get started. Desk. This is pretty much where I do a lot of my work, whether it's just surfing the net or editing videos and doing homework. It's pretty much here. This is where it happens. The desk is the same desk from my previous workstation tour that I talked about. It's a hand-me-down, so I didn't purchase it from any place or anything like that. It used to be that tan color, as you can see in the bottom, but I took the top and painted it white so that it kind of matches my entire workspace. And I didn't bother to paint the bottom white as well, since I just didn't feel like it and it doesn't really matter or anything like that. The chair is a Christmas present that I purchased for myself, and I got it from Office Works. And yeah, on top of my desk I've got my iMac, which I got from JB Hi-Fi. They had like a 10% off sale for it and I took advantage of that, so there's my keyboard and my mouse. And then behind that I've got a water bottle and a coaster that I got from Werribee Zoo. Next to my iMac on the right side, I've got some notebooks in here, as well as some DIY Midori-inspired traveler notebooks. I do have a video on how I made the pocket-sized one, and then I've got some fake succulents in here, as well as a clock, and then over there is a pencil holder that I made myself out of those tissue paper rolls that I covered with black paper, and it pretty much just holds my pencils, mechanical pencils in here, scissors, and then in here are some leads and then some charcoal and erasers on this smaller one. And then this right here is actually a wooden palette that I got from Daiso, and what I did was I fixed it onto the corner of this window. As you can see, that's pretty much the window right there, and I use it to put my calendar. This is a big calendar for the month of July, but obviously it has more months in the next pages, and I use this one as kind of like my planner for university, just to kind of keep track of dates and everything like that. And I start the semester 2 on the 27th, which I am not looking forward to, so yeah. Then over here I've got another Midori-inspired traveler's notebook. This one is the one that I'm currently using, since this is like my planner and all that kind of jazz, so that's what it looks like. If you want a video on that, let me know and I'll probably film one. Moving down, that is where I store my webcam, on that red box, and then there's just a plug over there for the lights. And then here I've got some A3 binders and folders, as well as some scrapbook paper. And then this thing that slides out, I made this kind of like divider thing, and it does slide out like this. And I keep all of my office supplies in here. So I've got like rulers, whiteout, post-it notes, and washi tape in here, some memo sheets in this tape, and then I've got some cutting tools like Stanley knife, and then I've got paper clips, binder clips, all that kind of jazz in here, as well as some glue sticks, glue tack, and some glue. And then I've got stickers and highlighters and more post-it notes. These are more like page flags that I use for planning. And then I've got some random stuff in here. I've got some first aid, USB, and we're back to rulers. And I did make this out of cardboard and some cardstock paper to cover it and make it white. And that's just what I put in here. And then it slides like that. Moving on to this part of my workspace, it's pretty much my wall where I put quote in here. It says, start where you are, use what you have, do what you love, which I totally, totally agree. And then I've got some of my own artworks in there, which I made into like prints and stuff and put them on my wall. And then here I made this kind of like banner, which says, work hard, stay humble. And then this is where I keep a lot of my art supplies. Starting on top, I've got this gold and white feather that I kind of just made as a decoration. And then here I've got some of my paint brushes, which I use for watercolor, as well as my Pentel Aquash in here. And I keep it in this tissue paper roll that I covered with gift wrapping paper. And then at the back, I've got graphite pencils and then some plastic tubs that I use for watercolor, like to put the water in. And then this is my white gouache, which is Art Spectrum Artist's Gouache in opaque white. And then I've got some Winsor & Newton art masking fluid and then some watercolors in here, which is my watercolor palette. You guys have seen me use that one. And I keep all of them in this acrylic case, which my Copic markers came in when I bought the 72 set. And then this is my Copic marker shelf right here where I store all of my Ciao markers, as well as some Touch Twin markers, which are my old markers. And this is just what they look like. And then at the bottom, I've got my refills and stuff and some random stuff in there. On top of my marker shelf, I've got this cute ornament that I got from Typo. I got a business card holder, but I store my ACO cards in here, so I do these little drawings and stuff. And then this one is an actual real succulent that I keep in here, and I put it in this little pot that I painted yellow and gold, and it's just a mini decoration as well as to add life into this workspace. Next to that, I have this container right here, which I made out of foam core board and scrapbook paper. It's the same materials that I use to make the Copic marker shelf right here. And I store my Prismacolor Premier pencils in here. So I did purchase the set of 132 finally, and I put them in here so that I could obviously use them and utilize them much better because they are quite expensive. And then down here I've got like this drawer unit, which I got from the dollar store. I got this one from the dollar store, and then I got this one from the dollar store, and I stacked them together so that it's nice and tall. On the first drawer, I've got my big market markers, and then I've got some Stabilo colorful fineliners in here, and then this one has some mechanical pencils. And then here I've got some gold and silver glitter pens and some micron pens in there. Here I've got my spare black fineliners. I've got a lot of ballpoint pens because I always buy them in bulk in the Philippines, so that's why I have quite a few. And then this one's kind of like a junk drawer or something, yeah. And then at the back I just have different rolls of paper, like it extends all the way there. And if I just take this out, you can kind of see them like that. So I've got a variety in there. I've got mostly tracing paper, a book cover, this is newsprint, and this at the back is Sorrel transfer paper, which I purchased from Dean's Art, and yeah. This paper bag is from Typo, and inside are just a few canvas or stretched canvases that I haven't used yet. I purchased them ages ago, mostly for year 12, but I think I already mentioned this in my previous workspace tour that I haven't really gotten around to using them since I'm not really into painting anymore now that I'm out of high school. This right here is a storage thing that I made out of wire, and I pretty much made it myself, and I use it to store some tape, like different kinds of tape, and then it has this thing that hangs and it can, stores tape as well. Okay, so moving on to my second desk, which is this one right here. I got this one from Officeworks, and it is the same desk from my previous workspace tour, but it's in white. And no, I did not paint this in white. What happened was I gave my the tan desk to my brother, and he pretty much paid for half of this, and I purchased this white one from Officeworks. And yeah, so it totally matches the whole white theme that I have going on. And this is where I do a lot of my work that's more on hands-on, and I don't have to use the computer. So any kind of filming or actually doing homework and writing and everything like that happens in here. That is why I like to keep it clean, or at least the top surface clean. And yeah. So starting on top, I've got these different novels that I got from the thrift store. And then here I've got a few things, a few ornaments that I got from Typo. And then that plastic tub, which contains some charcoal and wooden pencils in there. And then here I've got four boxes, which I made out of pizza boxes, and it has sketchbooks and notebooks in here. So as you can see, this one, it says pizza inside because it is made out of pizza boxes, and I just covered it with like this pink paper. And then this one has sketchbooks. Actually, this one's pretty much empty. And then this one has notebooks. And I actually had a lot more than this last year, but I tried to clear things out and reduced it down, but it's still quite a lot of things. Over here, this is where I keep different kinds of folders. So the black ones are just like random documents that I don't really need to go into because that has nothing to do with art or anything like that. And then these three are actually binders that I covered with scrapbook paper so that they're cute and pretty. They used to be like a color blue, purple, and green, and I wasn't really into that, so obviously I tried to cover it with scrapbook paper, as you can kind of tell. And this is where I keep all of my artworks and stuff like that. And then this magazine holder is also made out of pizza box. You can kind of see the brown carton right here, and I covered it with white paper so that it's all nice and clean. And then this is where I would normally store my school books and stuff, but as you guys know, I'm currently on my break, so this is where I'm currently storing different kinds of notebooks or sketchbooks that I am trying to fill in during this winter break. Right here I've got my books and stuff that are related to drawing. So I've already shown this in my previous workspace, but here is just another look in case you guys want to know what books I use for reference or just for inspiration. And then next to that I have that drawer unit that I got from Office Works. I got it for $10, which is quite cheap for a cool drawer system. On top I've got some watercolor pads that I got from Dean's Art. It is by the brand Draw and Wash, and I only purchased that one because I had like a gift card that I obviously needed to use, but otherwise I probably wouldn't have purchased it. And yeah, so this is actually made out of carton, but I didn't make it. I got it from Office Works, like I said. On the first drawer right here I've got different what do you call this, photo paper. Pretty much we've accumulated a lot of photo papers like this every time we purchase inks for the printer, so I'm keeping them right now. Since I was testing out how to make prints and stuff with our printer, and this is kind of just like an example, and yeah, so this is what I keep in this drawer right here. And then I've got some swatch paper in here. And then at the bottom, I've got some A5 white paper, as well as some colored paper that I use for studying. So this right here is my camera setup. And the only thing that's different, I do have a video for this, the only thing that's different is I added two lights on both sides, and the lights are from Bunnings, if you are wondering. They do clip on to the sides of this desk. And I changed the light bulb because they're actually spotlights, but I changed the light bulb into this spiral one so that it works better for my videos. That's why it kind of hangs out. This is currently where my camera is since I am trying to film some videos in advance so that I can have videos uploaded even when I'm already in university. On this corner, I have quite a few things. So the first thing is this succulent, which is also a real plant, and I put it on this small pot, which I got from the thrift store. It came with the yellow pot that you saw before, and I painted this one blue, and it has a gold triangle like that, which is pretty much inspired by Pinterest. This one is just an old gesso tub that I keep some erasers and sharpeners in there. And then this one is made out of Pringles container, and I covered it with scrapbook paper, and it now stores my Faber-Castell colored pencils in there. And then this one's also made out of the Pringles container and once again covered with scrapbook paper. And this is where I keep my black fineliners that I am currently using right now. And then I have this clay photo holder that I actually made because I was into polymer clay back then. And I use it as a photo holder for this mini original artwork that I've created, since it pretty much matches this entire corner right here, which is why I have it there. Moving down here, I've got a few things. So I've got that box over there, the pink one. It is from the Philippines. My friend gave it to me. It's native and I use it. It's actually an ottoman. I used it before as just a regular box, and then I found out that it's actually an ottoman, a native ottoman. So obviously now I use it as an ottoman and I put my feet on there whenever I'm working on the desk. And then on the left side, I've got a cutting mat and some few tins with some colored pencils in there. And then this is a box. It says Keji, and I store different supplies in here, like craft supplies, as well as some model making supplies that I use for my architecture course. And then on top, I've got a paper tray, which I made out of cardboard and pizza boxes once again, and I put my different kinds of papers in there that's usually meant to go to the recycling bin. Over here on this side is where I store my light box, which I made myself. I do get questions about it or how I made it, but honestly it's just a box and a light. You can kind of see the cord in there. And then I have this cow pencil case, which I put my pencil shavings, and then I have a DVD burner. On this first drawer right here, it's kind of like my food stash, so I've got a bunch of chocolates in there because I love chocolate. And then on this big drawer, I have all my paints and stuff. So I've got acrylic paints in here, and then I've got some sets in here, and then these boxes contain, some of them are empty because I emptied them out, but they contain like fabric paints. And then these ones are watercolor paints. And then I have some brushes in here that I use for acrylic, and then more fabric paints, some plastic tubs for water, and then some gesso in here. And then I've got some magazine posters, which I use as like the surface that I use to cover my desk whenever I'm painting, which doesn't happen actually since I don't really paint that much anymore. But yeah, so I've got everything in there since I used to use them back in high school. Moving on, we have this white table, which once again was a hand-me-down. I didn't purchase it or anything like that. It was given to me or given to us, and then I pretty much took it in. And I painted it white so that it matches my other desks. And on top, I have this black cutting mat, which I got from Kmart, which is so cool because it's black and it's not like the normal green ones that you commonly see. Underneath, I have this kind of like colorful drawer unit, which is empty. I used to store all of my highlighters, post-it notes, washi tape, all of those office supplies in here. But like as you saw before, I store them somewhere else now. So this one is currently empty and I don't know what to put in it. Underneath that, I have this black plastic crate, which I pretty much put in this upright position so that I can use it as like a shelf. So I've got different kinds of papers in here, but on this side I've got some more cutting mats. The pink one, which I got quite a few questions of where I got this. This is from Typo, but I haven't seen it at Typo ever since, so I'm not sure if they still sell that one. And then I've just got brown paper. These are watercolor papers, bleed-proof paper by the brand Art Tech, in case you're wondering. And then I've got some tracing paper, adhesive paper, which is by the brand, there it is, Quirky. And then some photo paper, sticker paper. Or not sticker paper, but like planner stickers. And then this is an A5 binder. Then I have some colorful papers in here, some more papers in here, and this is where I keep my smaller artworks, and then I've got some bigger papers in here. And then that black thing right here is what I use to carry my supplies to university, so it is just an A3 plastic carry case. I forgot to mention on this side are just a few boxes. This one contains some sketchbooks as well as these notebooks that I've made for my traveler's notebook. So those are kind of just notebook inserts. If you know about like Fodori, Midori, all that kind of jazz, those are notebook inserts. And you can pretty much make them yourself, which is what I do. And I will probably have a DIY video for that to accompany my previous DIY video, which was the Midori-inspired traveler's notebook. Finally, we reach the last part, which is this trolley right here, which I use as my main storage space for other things that I don't normally use on a regular basis. I got the trolley from Officeworks, and I got this plastic or acrylic case from Officeworks as well. On top, I have just a few magazines from university. And then the first drawer of this storage is some quill board or quill multiboard. And then I've got some reflex paper on the second one. In here, I've got some cream paper, which is also by the brand Quill. And then this one's also by the brand Quill. It's just some black paper. And then this one are some colored papers. On the first drawer, I just keep a bunch of random things, like it doesn't really make much sense. In here, this is where I keep any kind of artworks that I'm currently working on, but at the moment it just contains a bunch of random things. Like this one is the template that I use for my fashion illustrations, and I get a lot of questions about this one or how I made this one. And pretty much it's just cardboard, or I drew on cardboard. That's what it looks like. And cut it out. That's all I did. And that's pretty much it. On the next drawer, I just have a few coloring supplies. So these are mostly pencils and crayons in here. So as you can see, I have quite a few in here. On this one are some more coloring supplies, but these are more pastels, oil pastels, all that kind of jazz that I don't really use that often. But they're in here just in case because, like I said, I used them in high school. And then this has a tin, which I put my lino cutting tools in here. And then the next drawers are pretty much empty. This one has my Prismacolor tin that my pencils came in, and it's empty since I did move them. And these drawers are empty since I cleared them out and I tried to get rid of a few things, so yeah. Underneath this trolley, I do just have a few containers in there, which has some polymer clay as well as other air dry clays in there, since I was into polymer clay for a while when I was 14 years old, and I kind of want to get back into it, but I usually just like to use polymer clay during the summer and not during winter, since I don't know why. It gets really cold and my hands are pretty sensitive to the cold, so I try not to use polymer clay in the winter. And right over here, this is a tote bag that I got from Society 6, and oh my gosh, it is so freaking beautiful. It just hangs off there, and this is by Agnes Cecile, and I think that's how you say her name, I'm not really sure, but she does have a YouTube channel and you guys should check her out. I bought one of her merchandise and it is beautiful. This one is called Miss Violence. It's one of my favorite artworks of hers, and yeah, totally love it. This is what I'm going to use as my school bag for the next semester, totally. So this is my workstation, and yeah, that's what it looks like. I will pretty much end this video here. I am out of breath, and yeah. So I know I do have a lot of things, and even though I decluttered my workspace, it still remains to have a lot of things, but yeah, that's what it looks like, and it was my most requested video, so that's why I filmed it, and I hope you guys like this video. If you do, please do give this a thumbs up, and subscribe if you haven't already. You can also check out my social media links in the description box below, and that is it. Thank you guys for watching, and I will see you in my next one.